Okay, so yesterday DICE revealed the final five specialists coming to Battlefield 2042 at launch, and we got info on all of their unique gadgets and their traits. That's the passive ability that comes with each specialist. We're going to walk through those remaining five today, discuss their potential impact, and also sort of sum up the specialist situation going into the launch of 2042. Before that though, a quick word from today's sponsor, Alienware. They've not only hooked me up with a new gaming desktop PC, but also a new gaming laptop as well, the M15 R6. It's a powerful unit, this one, combining an Intel i7 8-core CPU, 16GB of RAM, and an NVIDIA RTX 3070 laptop GPU. Plenty of grunt to run Battlefield 2042 when it launches, and other games launching this year as well. The RTX 3070, it gives you access to great features like NVIDIA DLSS, that uses AI to upscale your games from a lower resolution, resulting in higher frame rates, and NVIDIA Reflex, a latency reduction tool for lowering the time it takes between you clicking your mouse and an action happening on the screen. And speaking of the screen, that's really what sets this laptop apart. It's an incredible 1440p 240Hz refresh rate panel. That's the same as what I'm using on my desktop PC. You're getting pretty much a desktop grade panel packed into a 15-inch laptop. You're getting proper gaming performance in a portable form factor. Plus, the build quality on this thing is really solid. I think Alienware have done a great job with this machine, and if you want to learn more about the M15 R5, and be sure to click the link at the top of the description. Okay, so let's walk through these five new specialists. The first is Santiago Espinosa, known as Dozer. He's classified as an assault specialist, and he comes with the ballistic shield as his unique gadget, and his passive trait is blast resistant. In the trailer for the specialist, we got to see both of these in action, with the ballistic shield seemingly able to deflect incoming bullets back at the enemy firing them, and then in the clip, killing that player. Now, this is somewhat alarming to me. We have had riot shields in Battlefield games before, but they just kind of like absorbed the incoming fire and they allowed players to like push through a choke point or a doorway or something like that. They were kind of strategic and situational, but they didn't deflect bullets back at enemies and then kill them. This to me seems very much out of place, and it could create some really frustrating gameplay moments where if you're fighting a Dozer character, suddenly they whip out their riot shield, and then you're punished for trying to shoot that player by the bullets doing a 180 and then coming straight back at you and damaging you. It seems like a really odd decision here from DICE, and personally, I'm not a fan of this one. The passive trait for Dozer though, blast resistant, this will let them take less damage and recover faster from explosive damage. Kind of like how some of the previous perks we had in Battlefield 3 and 4 worked back in the day. The clip in the video shows Dozer pretty much taking full damage from a grenade. He's standing right on top of it, but it's only applying half damage to his character, so you can see the reduction in damage there. Let me know what you think of this one. In fact, let me know what you think of all of the different specialists down below in the comment section today. I'm sure they're going to create some opinions. Next, we have Sundance, real name Emma Rosier, and they are also classed as an assault specialist. This is the wingsuit carrying specialist, or the flying squirrel, as it's been dubbed by the community since that Hazard Zone trailer. Their unique gadget is the smart explosive, and their passive trait is the wingsuit itself. Now, I'm really excited to give this specialist a go when the game launches, because I can already see all the amazing stunts and cool clips that people are going to be able to pull off when they whip out the wingsuit, and they just come careering into a situation in a way that no one really expects, a bit like in the trailer here. Seems like you've got a good amount of speed to the wingsuit, so you should be able to cover a lot of ground faster than most other specialists. Plus, once you land into the action, you've got these smart grenades that kind of seem to lock on to people and vehicles. Not really sure how I feel about this one. I kind of want to see it in proper gameplay rather than just a clip here, but you'll be able to select one of three different types of grenade, and it seems you do that by hitting what would be the plus menu button, but you hit that button when you're holding the grenade in front of you. You've got anti-armor, EMP, and then scatter grenades. And in the clip, we see them use the scatter grenade to kill a bunch of infantry, and then the anti-armor grenade that seems to just fly and home onto a helicopter and blow it up in one hit. This looks a bit weird to me, and it depends on how many of these grenades you can carry as to whether we can really say that this specialist is balanced or not, but certainly a different take nonetheless. Next up, we have Rao. He is a recon specialist, and his abilities are about hacking enemy players and objects and controlling other parts of the map as you're playing. The Trojan Network gadget allows him to hack an enemy player, sort of like marking them up for a kill, and then when you kill that marked player, nearby players will be pinged with a red marker, so the hack reveals enemy locations, but you have to kill the hacked player. And then also, he has the Cyber Warfare Suite, which can hack enemy equipment and in-world objects. Here the example is letting teammates through on a tuk-tuk before hacking the bollards and raising them up to stop an enemy vehicle following them, which is kind of cool. I'm not really sure with the fast pacing of Battlefield 2042 that Rao is going to be super effective, especially with it being quite situational and needing to hack things that are in your vicinity. And it might just be easier to kill players that are standing in front of you rather than hacking that player and then killing them and then killing a couple of others. I mean, in this clip here, they could have just moved forward, killed the first player, turned and killed the second player without needing to hack. But again, you know, we've only got a very small window, a very small example of how it works. So again, we'll need to wait for wider gameplay to come out or wait for the full game to come out so we can see how this really, really works. But it does seem like a specialist that you could use for like setting traps and things like that. So if that's your style, then maybe Rao's for you. Next is Jisoo Pike from South Korea. They're a recon specialist like Rao, and they're equipped with some extremely concerning items. This one will be fun to talk about. Specialty gadget is the EMGX scanner, and their trait is threat perception. Threat perception highlights enemy players that do damage to you. So it's kind of like a reverse spot because you're not actively trying to spot that player, but they shot at you, so they get pinged up on your 3D HUD. That's going to be helpful if you don't know who shot you, or maybe you're like close to cover and then you take damage, but you can dive behind the cover and still know where an enemy is to try and take them out once you've healed up. Could work quite well. And then the scanner, well, this basically gives Pike a wall hack. DICE says it displays an electromagnetic overlay of hostiles in cover. So the in cover part gives me hope that this isn't going to be ridiculously overpowered, because it literally is a wall hack. But in this clip here, we see the scanner beams up red overlays on enemy players in the vicinity, and then Pike just goes and kills them all. No word on whether this ability alerts enemies that Pike has just scanned them and that they've been revealed. That would be a really welcome addition, so at least you know that you've been sort of hit with a wall hack. Some warning would be nice. But being totally frank here, this to me just isn't a good idea at all, and I'm quite surprised to see it here in Battlefield 2042, even though it does kind of fit into the future theme of the game. You know, sometimes those things sound cool on paper, but they're really bad for gameplay, and I can already see this being really bad for gameplay. You can actually see here in this clip that a player that was marked with the red overlay, they lose the overlay as they step out of cover, and then they regain the overlay again as they move behind cover, those big massive wheels of the container mover as it goes over them. I guess that shows that the DICE team, when they designed this, they thought that having enemies painted red for the entire duration of the scan was quite powerful, so at least there's some kind of occlusion there. But that's just taking it from the clip that we have. That's the only context we've got, so we'll have to wait for more gameplay, but even in this very small clip that we've seen here, I am not a fan of this scanner thing at all. It's just a wall hack, and it just doesn't sit right with me. And then lastly, we have Angel, a support specialist, and his special gadget is the loadout crate, and his trait is trauma specialist. The loadout crate can be called in, and it provides ammo and armor pickups for your squad, which is nice, but it also gives you the ability to change to a different loadout during live gameplay. Now, you might remember this from Battlefield 4 as the Commander Crate. That could be called in by a commander that was on the server. It would drop down, you could run over to it, and you could switch to another loadout. It looks exactly the same here in 2042, but it's applied to a specialist instead of the commander. And it's kind of like an extension beyond the plus system, which lets you change attachments during live gameplay. The crate allows you to pick up another loadout with new weapons and gadgets entirely. And then his trauma trait allows him to revive players to full health and restock their armor pouch with that revive as well. This seems like a really good specialist for people who just like supporting others out there on the battlefield. And in Hazard Zone, I could see Angel being an absolute lifeline for the squad if they need supplies or they want to change their loadout. So those are the five new specialists for Battlefield 2042, and we now know the full list of 10 for the launch of the game. What's the verdict here? Well, personally, I think Pike and Dozer are going to need looking at, as their unique gadgets do seem overpowered and potentially game-breaking when it comes to Pike's wallhack scanner thing. Honestly, I just take that out of the game. That seems ridiculously overpowered, but overall, there are a lot of different styles to choose from, and each specialist does have a role that is different from the others, although some of them are quite close together. I am still concerned, though, that the entire construct of specialists is rather fragile. In Hazard Zone, I think specialists make total sense, and personally, I feel like they were actually designed for that game mode in mind. In All Out Warfare, though, when you're playing Conquest or Breakthrough, I don't think their impact is going to be as profound, since gameplay is happening on a much larger scale, and one individual specialist's ability to change a situation will be diluted somewhat. But since we've only played with the four of the specialists in the open beta, I personally don't have enough experience with the system to draw many more conclusions, other than having that second gadget slot as an open pick. That seems a bit dangerous to me. That second open slot, it risks replacing the structured class system that we've known from previous Battlefield games for some time with a more selfish approach. And whilst that sounds bad for Battlefield, which has always had this team and squad play focus, it seems that DICE isn't really concerned with that anymore. And this tweet here kind of solidifies that, mentioning that you can just customize the rest of your loadout beyond picking the specialist. The traditional separators that were built into Battlefield's class system, they're all but gone in Battlefield 2042. And based on the fact that there's been really no change from the open beta to the reveal of these five new specialists, I think we can be confident that DICE isn't going to change anything for the launch of this game. Specialists, they're here to stay, for better or for worse, it seems. Time will tell, and once we get our hands on the full game in November, I think we'll all be able to draw proper conclusions with time playing with the 10 specialists, but right now, it seems that they're here to stay, and they're not really changing that much at the moment. But thanks very much for watching, I appreciate you all, and I'll catch you in the next one.